Hello, good morning dear students. In today's class I am going to start the important question. We'll discuss what are the 5 marks important question from the chapter number 2, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Already I completed this chapter in the previous classes, and now in today's class we'll discuss the 5 marks important question on this topic. So whatever I'll explain you today, you just remember that these are the important questions in exam point of view. So today we'll discuss only the 5 marks. First we'll discuss the 5 marks important question, then we'll go to the 3 marks, 2 marks and 1 marks questions. Okay, so we'll start with this first, the 5 marks question from this topic, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Okay, I'll write here. Chapter number 2, and that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. From this topic today we will discuss what are the important 5 marks questions. Okay, I'll write here 5 marks questions. Today minimum we discuss 2-3 questions in today's class. Okay, so whatever I will write the questions on the board, and I will write the answer also, means if the diagrams are there I will draw on the board, you also note down in your book. So you have to follow while studying. These are the important questions. So first question we'll discuss, question number 1. So the question number 1 is, explain the structure of yellow flower. With a neat labeled diagram, So this is the question. First question. See, in first topic, I taught you about the sexual reproduction in flowering plant, means in the angiosperms how the sexual reproduction takes place. Already in the first topic you have studied what is the reproduction and what are the types, that is asexual and sexual. And now in this second topic you have to study specially in angiosperms the sexual reproduction. So in sexual reproduction in flowering plants, so angiosperms are the flowering plants, and in that which one is the reproductive structure? The flower is the reproductive structure. So remaining part of the plant body are the vegetative structures, vegetative part of plant body, and the flower only is known as the reproductive part, which can take parts in the reproduction, that is sexual reproduction. So the first question from this topic is, we'll discuss about the, explain the structure of LSO flower with a neat labeled diagram. So before going to see about the reproduction, you should know the structure of flower. Okay, so I will draw the diagram here, and with me you also have to draw. I will draw the rough diagram and then I'll explain the points about that flower. Okay, so while drawing this I will tell you briefly the parts. So this is centrally I drawn you the gynoecium, you know that, which is the female reproductive structure, and these are the petals I'm drawing here. So these are nothing but what? Corolla. This is a very important because it will be asked you in the examination. 5 marks. Okay, very simple diagram, and it will ask you in the examination for 5 marks. this is what I am drawing here, the rough stage of the flower, and that is LSF flower. I will give the name, figure name is LSF flower. Okay. These are the androtiums what I am drawing here. These are the anthers. So now we label the parts. Okay. Before that, this is the ovary. Okay. So what are the parts now? This is pedicel, stalk of the flower, and this region we can call it as thalamus. Okay, and this is calyx, this is corolla, this one is the androecium. This is centrally gynoecium. Okay, so see, I have drawn here the structure of the LSF flower. So first of all, I'll tell you that this is the flower, and the flowers are borne on the branches. They may be present on the stem and the branches. So as the flower has the stalk, a cylindrical stalk-like structure, which is called as the pedicel. If the flower has the stalk, then that flower is called as a pedicellate flower. So do you remember that the stalk of the flower is called as the pedicel? So the pedicel is a cylindrical structure. At the tip of the pedicel, this pedicel is called like a swollen, and this is called as the thalamus. So thalamus is the region from where all the parts of flower can be grown. So this is called as the thalamus. At the tip region of the pedicel, it is like a swollen structure, and then that structure is called as the thalamus. Then these are the two parts, and then remaining the important parts of this flower is the main are there four. First one is the calyx, corolla, androecium, and the gynoecium. So these are the four important parts of the flower, which is distributed into two different walls. Okay. So two different wall, in that the first one is, we can call it as the accessory wall, or it is also called as helping wall. Okay, so this is the one, and the second one is the essential or reproductive wall. So now these are the two walls of the flower, and which is distributed into four parts. So what are that? In the accessory wall, first we'll see. So these are the accessory walls, are what? The outermost wall of the flower, and here these are also known as a helping wall, because they may be helps to the flower, which helps to the plant at the time of reproduction and fertilization and the process of pollination. So in the accessory wall, what will come? The first part will come, that is calyx. Okay, and then second will come corolla. You can see here, this one is the calyx, this is a green color, and this is the corolla. So first we'll go through the calyx. First, the calyx is the outermost part or outermost wall of the flower, which is green in color. And what the function of this calyx is? This can be helps to the flower at the time of bud condition. So whenever the flower is in a bud condition, it is completely covered by the calyx. So the function of calyx is what? It gives the protection to that developing flower. So the calyx, individual unit of the calyx is called as the sepals. The calyx is made up of the many units, and the individual unit of this calyx is called as the sepals. And then here the sepals are arranged in a different flower in a different position. So if the sepals are fused, then the condition is called as what? Gamosepalous. And if the sepals are free from each other, and they are known as the polysepalous. What it means, see, these are the what? I will tell, this is the calyx. Okay? So, calyx here, it is made up of individual unit. The number may be of 3, 4, 5 or many more. So, if the 5 numbers are there, if the calyx means it is made up of individual unit and these all are the free from each other, then this condition is called as a polysepalous. And in some flowers, these sepals are fused, okay, like this it is fused and this is called as what? Gamosepalous. So, this is about the calyx. Next one is the second part of the flower, that is corolla, which is also the accessory whorl or the helping whorl. You can see here it is. Okay, this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see in this diagram the 5 are there. Okay, means one corolla but 5 petals are there. So, the individual unit of this corolla is called as the petals. Got the point? The petals are also made up of the different units and an individual unit of the corolla is called as the petals. And here you can see this corolla is a varied color. Means the different colors of corollas or the petals are there. And what is the function of this corolla? This corolla will be helps to the plant body at the time of pollination. Because see, corolla has the different colors and which is the attracting colors to the birds and the animals, and they can reach to that plant, and then here they will be helps to the process of pollination. So, this corolla is also, the arrangement of corolla or the petals are also of two types. In one condition they are fused, in one condition they are free. See, these are the petals. If they are fused with one another, like this, if they are fused, then it is called as the gamopetalous. If these petals are free from each other, like this, then it is called as a polypetalous. So, this corolla and the calyx, these are the two parts of the flower which is called as the accessory whorl or the helping whorl. Because it gives or it helps to the plant body at the time of process of pollination and fertilization. Just remember this much, okay? Next is, the second whorl of the flower is the reproductive whorl. Reproductive whorl means what? The parts of flower which takes parts in the process of reproduction. So, what are that? These are the two. First one is the androecium and second one is the gynoecium. So, androecium and gynoecium, these are the two reproductive part of the flower. And then, they are also known as the essential whorl or it is the reproductive whorl. Essential means what? It is needed for the process of reproduction. And these are the two parts of the flower which takes part in the reproduction. So, it is called as a reproductive whorl. Got the point? So, first we come here, androecium. Androecium. And the second will come, gynoecium. Okay. So, now here, first you see the androecium. Okay. So, this is the androecium. The number of androecium also varied from flowers to flower, different flowers. And then, this androecium is nothing but, it is called as a male reproductive structure. Androecium is male reproductive structure. And the individual unit of the androecium. So, as this calyx and corolla is made up of individual units, similarly the androecium is made up of the individual units, and that individual unit is called as the stamen. Individual unit of androecium is called as the stamen, and which has the three parts. Okay? Which are those? Anther, connective and filament. See here, this is the individual androecium, which is called as, one unit is called as the stamen, which has three parts. Which are those? See, this one is the anther, this is the filament and this is the region where this anther and filament is connected, and that is called as the connective. So this is about the male reproductive structure, that is androecium. Now we move to the next one. Is the last part is the gynoecium. The gynoecium is the innermost part. Okay, it is present at the center and it is very innermost part of the flower, and which is called as gynoecium, which is nothing but the female reproductive structure. Female reproductive structure. Okay, so the gynoecium is also called as pistil. Gynoecium is also called as pistil, and the gynoecium is made up of the units, and the individual unit of the gynoecium is called as carpel. Just remember, carpel. Okay, the individual unit of gynoecium is the carpel, and which is also distributed into three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. Okay, so these are the three parts of the carpel. You can see in this diagram, this is what the single carpel. So this region is called as the stigma, and this is the hollow stalk-like structure is called as the style, and this is the ovary, which is the female reproductive structure. So this is about briefly about the LS of flower. If in examination the question is asked for 5 marks, explain the structure of LS of flower, then you have to draw this diagram and you have to explain the points what I have explained in this class today. If sometimes the question may be asked, draw a neat table diagram of LS of flower. It may be asked for 3 marks, means only diagram. Whenever the term will come, only draw the diagram. You have to draw only diagrams. If the question is come, explain the structure, explain what will come, at that time you have to draw the diagram and also you have to explain the points. I think you have understood the question number 1, what we have discussed now. Is it clear? Okay. So now we will move to the second question. Second question from this topic. So as we have seen the reproductive parts, that is androecium, gynoecium. Next we have to see the development of male and female gametes. Already we have seen that. And now the question, the second question is arises about the male reproductive structure, that is androecium. Okay. We will write the second question. I will write here. You also note down. Question number 2. Okay, so the question number 2 is describe or explain. Both words are same. I'll write here describe the structure of microsporangium. Which is also called as teres of anther. Remember both the words for this. Okay. Describe the structure of microsporangium with labeled diagram. See, listen, the one point is, the question may be asked, describe the structure of microsporangium or explain the structure of microsporangium. If in that question it is not mentioned, means diagram, about the diagram with a labeled diagram. If it is not mentioned, then also you have to draw the diagram. Remember, one point is the concept based on the what the questions will come. If that concept have the diagram, then along with the diagram you have to explain, then only you will get the complete 5 marks. Otherwise, your marks will be cut. If you are explained, you are not drawn the diagram, then 2 marks or 2.5 marks will be reduced. So remember the point, if it is not mentioned the labeled diagram, then also you have to draw the diagram whenever the question is describe or be explained. Okay. So already in this question, it is clear that they have asked, the question is describe the structure of microsporangium, that is TS of anther, with labeled diagram. In sometimes, if they will ask you the microsporangium. और sometime they will ask you describe the structure of TS of anther like this. So what is that? We'll see. So I will draw here the rough diagram of this microsporangium. From these topics, see, the biology is a subject in which the diagrams are very important. If the answer without a diagram is there, then you will not get the complete 5 marks. Diagrams are very important and they are necessary. So, whatever the diagrams will tell you the important at the time of teaching you, then you have to make practice of that diagrams. This is the rough sketch I am drawing here. So this is, you already know that the microsporangium is circular in outline, which is the tetrasporangiate, and here mainly they have the 4 wall layers, protecting wall layers. This is second one. This is third one, and now this is the innermost. Okay. This is the TS of anther. When we take the section of anther, the structure is like this. That is tetrasporangium and it is bilobed. Now I will draw here a diagram explaining the one sporangia, that is, I'll draw here. Like this, then what the first wall layer is there here, that wall layer name is epidermis, and next will come endothecium. Then will come the middle layer, and in the most will come is the tapetum. Okay. And try to draw the diagram neatly. Okay, if your diagrams are not neat, and if it is without label, then you will not get complete marks. Okay. So this is what I am drawing here. Consider these are the rough diagram. In the notes, I have given you the clear diagrams. You have to follow that. Okay. And here, innermostly, there is a presence of a mass of embryonic tissues, which are nothing but sporogenous tissues. Okay, got the point? Now I will label this. Okay, I will write the labelings here. This epidermis. Okay, and from here it is like this. And then next will come, draw like this. So this one is the endothecium. Here it is, second one. Then this one is the middle layer. And from here it is, this one is the middle layer. And the innermost of this is the tapetum. here, this one is a topic. Then the center, sporogenous tissue. So these were the sporogenous tissue. Here it is present. Okay, so listen now, I'll explain you the points. This is the diagram of microsporangium, and that is nothing but the layers of anther. So as you know that anther is what? It is the part of the stamen, and stamen is what? It is the male reproductive structure. So as first we'll go through, androecium is the male reproductive structure. Individual unit of the androecium is the stamen. Stamen has the three parts, anther connective filament. So anther which possesses the pollen grains, the development of male gamete takes place inside the anther. So this is the question based on the anther. So whenever we take a section of anther, so as you know that the angiospermic anther is the bilobed like this. One, two lobes are present. If we take the section, that is TS means what? The transverse section of anther, then the structure is like this. So this is the question based on the TS of anther, that is microsporangium. In this question, we have to draw the diagrams and we have to explain the points about the microsporangium. So already I have drawn the diagram here. You can see this is the diagram and this is the one expanded portion of this microsporangium. First of all, I will start with the first point is you have to write the angiospermic microsporangium is the circularly outline. And which is the tetrasporangiate? Tetrasporangiate means the four sporangia are present. Microsporangia, okay, sporangium. So this is the 1, 2, 3 and 4. And this angiospermic anther is the bilobed, means two lobes are present and each lobe possesses the two pollen sacs. It is called as the pollen sacs or the microsporangium or microsporangia. And then, so this is the angiospermic microsporangium has the four wall layers. Okay, what four wall layers are present and which are those? One is the epidermis, second one is the endothecium, third one is the middle layer, fourth one is the tapetum. So these are the four parts are there. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So these are the parts which are nothing but what? The wall layers of the anther. So now here, what is the function of these wall layers? What it can carry the function? First one is this epidermis, this endothecium and middle layer. So these are the three outermost wall layers of the microsporangium. And this function of these three wall layers is, that is epidermis, middle layer and endothecium. The function of this is protection. And it also helps in the dehiscence of anther. Dehiscence of anther means when the male gamete will get mature inside the anther wall will get ruptured and all the male gametes comes out of the microsporangium. So that process of rupturing of the anther wall is called as what? The dehiscence of anther. And who will help at the time of dehiscence of anther? These are the three wall layers, epidermis, endothecium and middle layer. You just remember the function of these three wall layer is one is the protection and another one is they will help in the dehiscence of anther. Next one is the fourth wall layer. So this one is the fourth wall layer and which is called as the innermost. So this tapetum is the innermost wall layer of this microsporangium which is filled with the reserve food material. Okay, which is filled with the reserve food material and it possesses a dense cytoplasm with many nuclei. So you can see here this is the tapetum layer which is the innermost. Now here what is the function of this tapetum? I will tell you. See, first of all I will tell about the central tissues which are present. You can see here at the center of this each lobe of this microsporangia what is present? A compact mass of young and embryonic cells are present. You can see compactly they are arranged. And this compact mass of embryonic cells are called as the sporogenous tissue. So these are the sporogenous tissues which later develops into the male gametes. They may develop into the pollen grains. So this tapetum as it is filled with the reserve food material. So the function, main function of this tapetum is the they gives or they nourishes the developing pollen grains. Means at the time of development of pollen grain, this sporogenous tissue develops into pollen grain. So at the time of development of pollen grain, this tapetum will be gives the nourishment to this developing pollen grain. So the function of tapetum, just remember, it gives the nourishment to the developing pollen grains. So this is about the structure of, describe the structure of microsporangia with a labeled diagram. If the question is asked, you have to draw this diagram and you have to explain all the points. I think you have, this point is clear to you. Okay. So the two questions we have discussed in today's class, that is, one is the LS of flower, and the second question I have discussed is the structure of the microsporangia, that is nothing but TS of anther. So from this topic, two questions we have discussed today, and the remaining questions we will discuss in the next class. Until that, stay home, stay safe. I will tell you one point is, you have to make practice of drawing these diagrams. Later, we will send you in Google Classroom assignments on this topic. Okay? Thank you.